Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night. This is Torrin Atkinson with another weekly 20-minute monster. Today we are going to do the Meenlock from the Fiend Folio. It was a tough decision. I put forward a few options over the course of the week to the various Facebook groups. Mesodemon was one of them. Mantari was another one of them. They're all good choices, but when I read the write-up for Meenlock, something came into my head, something that I wanted to draw. So there was, and somebody suggested a mountain man, and I decided that mountain man should be a mage. So I'm going to draw some Meenlocks menacing a manly mountain mage. So that should be fun drawing. In the news this week, here's a Cthulhu beholder that I drew last night with pen and ink. Because, frankly, I was bored. And sometimes when you're bored, you just draw. So that's good. That's available to own, in case anybody wants an original Torrin Atkinson artwork. What else happened this week? Oh, yes. After last Sunday's 20-Minute Monster Lavage Children, I decided... that was double me, because I decided to... Let me just get it. Oh, yeah, I decided to do another in my series of... Can we move this? No, we don't. Can't move that.
And they also appeared in
The Valley of the Unicorns. Storyboard Artist Reacts to episode number 4 of the Dungeons & Dragons cartoon. So you can find that on my YouTube channel. Just Google Torrin Atkinson, and I won't torture you with that right now. But, I'm having a lot of fun doing those. Big fan of the D&D cartoon, and I'll be doing more of them in the future. Okay, so now, all right, let's get to the Meenlocks. Where's my stylus? Here we go. Okay. As always, you can find my artwork online. I've been drawing D&D monsters since probably 1996 or 1997, back in the days of TSR. So I have a bunch of my art online available to own. And my website, which you can see at the top of the screen, torrinatkinson.com/artwork/originalartforsale. Also, Patreon. Hey, how about a dollar? Can I have a dollar? Give me a dollar. I stream these on twitch.tv/torrinatkinson. Then I put them on my YouTube channel. And don't forget, I put all my crap on my Instagram, Torrin Atkinson Artist. So that is that. Today, it's the Meenlock. Oh, yes. There's a lot of text, but it's all relevant, so I'm sorry, but I'm going to read. I'm going to read to you now. It's story time. Dungeons & Dragons story time. Charles Smith Org is here in the chat. Welcome. So, Meenlock, this is from the Fiend Folio. As I said, they are size small, 2 feet tall. They have special defenses, dimension door, special attacks, paralysis. They move 9 inches. That can't be right. Meenlocks are small bipedal creatures about 2 feet tall and covered in black shaggy fur. Their heads are white, cut with dark ridges. Let's take a look at that head. Yes, indeed. In total, they present a horrid appearance that will cause fear in any person, thus causing the victim to... this causes the victim to fall inert on the ground. Oh, my God. Meenlocks have their lair in dark sealed vertical shafts underground. If the seal is removed, the bottom of the shaft cannot be seen, and anything dropped in will land noiselessly on a thick moss carpet which lines the walls and floor of the shaft. The shaft will be dark, and smell of rotting corpses will drift upwards. Characters other than the most insensitive will also detect a strong emanation of evil, even without the use of detect evil spell. After descending vertically for 20 feet or so, the shaft twists and curves, so it is impossible to see the bottom, even with a light spell, which will only reveal detail of the upper parts. Interesting, interesting, interesting. If brave adventurers penetrate the shaft, oh my, they will eventually find the Meenlock lair, a large space like a small cave. Wait, a large space. So a large, small cave. So a medium cave at the very foot of the shaft. The creatures will always attack. Exception. Bright light will cause them to flee and will use their claws. The touch of the Meenlock causes paralyzation at close quarters, such as in their lair. However, the Meenlock's telepathic powers are virtually useless. This is the reason for their artificial smell of rotting corpses, which they deliberately create in order to deter entrance to the lair. The creatures will use considerable ingenuity to extinguish sources of light, torches, lanterns, etc. They have a limited dimension door ability over a distance of 6 feet every other round. When using this ability, attacks on them are blah, 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 blah. However, they cannot use the power when carrying a victim. 3 meenlocks are required for such attacks. We're not going to be, I don't think we're going to have anyone carrying anyone, but that's a good idea. Maybe we will. if adventurers remove the seal from the top of the shaft. I'm curious about the seal. Is it just like a rock? Or is it like some kind of a seal that they make? I don't know. Maybe it's a marine seal. From the top of the shaft, but subsequently fail to penetrate the Meenlock's lair, that the creatures will take fullest advantage. When the adventurers depart, they will be followed at a safe distance by the nasty little beasts, which can climb quickly and noiselessly up the shaft by using the deadening qualities of the moss. One of the adventurers will be marked by the Meenlocks, selected at random, and the Meenlocks will concentrate their subsequent attacks on him alone, being highly evil and greatly desirous of wreaking vengeance upon humankind. The victim selected would always be human if one is present, but if not, the creatures would choose an elf, dwarf, or any other near human. From the time of his marking onwards, the chosen victim will receive disturbing telepathic messages. The Meenlock can communicate telepathically over a 300-foot range. My God! The message will vary in content, but the threat will be the same, that the Meenlocks are pursuing the victim relentlessly and intend to make him one of them. The victim will also be conscious of stealthy movement in the shadows. Companions of the victim, these are all illusory and induced telepathically. Companions of the victims will hear and detect nothing and may conclude that their colleague is mentally aberrant. The Meenlocks will not attack until the party beds down to rest. However, until that time, the victim will become increasingly preoccupied with the predicament and will be able to concentrate less and less upon his adventure. When the party, including the victim, has bedded down to rest, the Meenlocks will attack, moving very silently. They will attempt to silence any guards and drag their victim away. If they succeed in doing so, they will take the victim to their shaft, sealing it after entry. After a short but gruesome treatment, the victim himself becomes a Meenlock. So that's a great... I really like all of that. It seems weird to me that this is so very specific. Like, it almost seems like a real... Like, I thought this guy was based on a fairy tale or something. But when I looked it up on Wikipedia, nothing. So, there's our Meenlock reference from the Fiend Folio. And, of course, sometimes we like to look at other editions. Here's a second edition Meenlock. Not quite as shaggy fur-ful. But pretty good. What's the difference between these two? The new one has more of a nose, like a humanoid nose, which is, I'm trying to decide, should I do some kind of hybrid version between these two or just stick to the first one? We'll see. We'll see. So the current time is 10:07, as I like it to be sometimes. This seems to be when I usually start. I've chosen maroon. It's going to be a maroon. Here's our maroon. Is this the right? Yeah, that's the right. Although, let me check here. Should I take ultra bleed for a more scraggly line? Yeah, let's try that. Is that also... I want to see if there's... This one doesn't have any... Okay, we'll go back to the one we had because it has more of a... You can... Transparency to it. All right. Good enough. Let me get rid of all these. Control A, delete. All right. Now it's 10:08. We wasted time. So what we're gonna do? Let's start. 10:28 is our end time. So here's our ground plane. We're gonna have our manly mage sitting on a log, maybe. His feet. So maybe he's got a staff, and then a log. So there's the log. And let's move him up a bit, and then we can get some scary trees. Scary trees. Where is everyone today? I'm used to only one viewer. Normally we get. I mean, sometimes we get one, but I, like it when we have more than one. Although I appreciate that you're here, Charles Smith Org. Some spooky trees. Maybe we'll put some meenlocks up in the trees. I feel like they might be a little bit too close. Let's put him a little bit more in the distance. Nervously. Nervously. I want to... Why can't I select B? Okay, here's it. Let's put and one meanlock standing on another. They're only 2 feet tall, remember? So is that enough meanlocks? Should there be many more meanlocks? To go with the M. Okay, I think that's a basic composition. So let's start with our mad mage, our mad manly mage. So he's not leaning forward so much because I want to see more. I want to emphasize his manly chest. So maybe he should be like, diligent. I feel like he's definitely gonna have a beard because he's gonna have a manly beard. And then let's, I feel like 30. Maybe 30 is too. He's a manly mage. Gaunt. Let's make him gaunt. Should I make his beard a little more manly? I feel like his head's too big, but we can change that later. Looks kind of... I don't want him to look like Santa Claus, but he might end up looking like Santa Claus. Right? Or should his eyes be big? I don't know. I can't decide. I like this. I like them both. Should have a skull cap on? You know how the manly mages sometimes have? Not just any mage of any kind, have those. Sure, let's give him, like from the Unearthed Arcana. Okay, there's this cap. Alright, so let's... Yeah, that head is way too big. Funny, though. Okay. Give him a manly neck and a manly chest coming out of his robe. Look at that. Look at that manly chest. I mean, a manly. He needs more shadow. But not too much. Don't go overboard, Torin. Alright. And we give him, like, I don't know. Some hair. Should we give him a necklace of some kind? An amulet? The 12th talisman? To go back to the D&D cartoon? Oh, I totally forgot about my music. How embarrassing. My God. Sorry. iTunes is loading, I hope. Is it loading? There it is. Okay. That's embarrassing. No wonder nobody showed up. Let's get some, yeah. There we go. That's a little better. Do-do-do-do-do. And now we're cooking with gas. More hair. Needs more hair. You can draw a nipple. Manly nipple. And then he's got, these are his robes, but he's going to be a muscly mage. We can give like a trim on his, emphasize his. Right? Get rid of all that. We'll do the staff later. Maybe he should be holding a staff. Maybe that would be more. But not in. Yeah, this would be a staff here, let's say. This is his manly bicep. Something like that. And his legs. Again, I feel like I'm drawing him too large in the. But we can change all that later. Knee, toes, sandals, I guess. Dun, 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 dun. What's going on with this foot here? There's the manly mage. He's got trim there, and he's got trim here. Right? Does that make sense? There's our manly mage. His staff, his wizard staff. Another gem of some kind, I don't know. What should be? Is it just a marble? No. Whatever. It's a mage staff. Let's zoom out. Let's check on our mage. All right, our mage is, again, way too big. Let's move him. Like, maybe here-ish? I'm gonna get that log. He should have a little campfire, too, I think. Maybe I'll put him. I'm not gonna have him looking directly at the. Let's move his eyes over here. Yes, he's nervous. He's a nervous mage. All right. Now, I get it. I said now we're cooking with gas, but now we're drawing with music. Thank you, Charles Mitchell. Oh, well, that's, I meant to brush there, not. All right. Which. If I'd drawn the fire first, I would have known where to put the shadows. But. I can feel like the shadows. So this would be like the heaviest shadows would be on this side. But also, where's the log? The tree log. Tree log? Is that what you call them? We don't need to worry too much about the log.
My grandfather's clock was too large for the shelf, so it stood 90 years on the floor.
Something like that. That's fine.
It was taller by half.
The shadow, the shadow should be like over here.
Not a penny weighed more. It was bought on the morning,
right?
The day that he was born, and must
and this
would
just all be
like
that. And that's fine. That's fine. Now let's draw some Meenlocks. Let's check out our Meenlock. Well, how are we doing for time? 10:18. We're halfway through. So let's draw some Meenlocks. I feel like. Maybe. I don't want them all looking at him. I want one of them looking. Maybe this guy is the one who's looking at the. I'll give them. I will give them. No, I'm not going to give them a nose. Fangs. It's hard to tell what direction they're looking at, though, when they don't have pupils. I'm in a bit of a rush, I guess. I'm still in the right layer, right? Yes, I am.
Never to go again when the old man died. 90 years with a slumbering.
Is that supposed to be his mouth? I guess it is. A little beard. Okay, great. Our first Meenlock. And then as well as Meenlocks. I'm just going to move this over so I can.
Never to go again when the old there. Man dies.
This is kind of hard. Ooh. Okay, center line down to here. Maybe you do it that way, it's a little bit easier. It's Disco Star Trek. I wonder if this is going to get flagged. Probably. Okay. And then he's standing on top of this other guy. But did I draw the Meenlock too big? Maybe I did. Let's shrink him down just a little bit. Let's draw. This guy. His head. His fangs. Bugs. And I was noticing in the later editions they look more like bugs. Right? I think it looks right. Some fangs. How are we doing for time? 10:22. I gotta get cracking because I gotta finish drawing the trees. I may have put too many Meenlocks. Shoulder. They don't have tails, do they? No. Just sitting on his buddy. Absolutely normal. Oh, those hairs. Gotta draw those hairs. He's got two. There's gonna be a lot of shadow in this drawing, I think. They're all away from the campfire. But it might also look super messy. Sometimes that's just the way it goes. Not really gonna draw his other. The sound from the motion picture. What am I drawing here? That's a mess. Okay, moving on to the next guys. This is all like. They're supposed to be behind a tree. Where's the roots of the tree? This is the tree. Spooky tree. Does that look like a tree? Looks more like a hand, but that's fine. Some suggestion of leaves. That's good enough. Because we can put another layer of shadow underneath here just to really emphasize things. Okay, so that's those guys. We got one in the... tree here and the branches. I can move this back over to where it was. Everybody is hairy. Yes, that's true. Meenlock at the door. Run away quick. Or you'll run no more. How's this guy hanging onto the tree? Now that I'm drawing him, I'm like, what? Let's put his arm there. No. What should I do here? It's back. And he's hanging on to a branch or something. He's sitting on a branch? And then his other hand would be here. Which we won't worry about too much. Not gonna worry about that too much. Hairy body. Let me take another look at my reference. Put that on. I mean, they look like they have ant insect joints. So maybe I'll lean into that a little bit more. I'm not sure about the body, though. Only this guy has whoops. At the edge of my canvas here? Let me check. Do I need more room? Do I need to make everything a little bit smaller? So I can... that's fine. What are we at? Oh my god, I only got 1 minute left. I'm always going over lately. Just gonna add the hair here. Add the hair. Something like that. Right? And then the last guy. He's really gonna be peeking around the corner here. True profile. Should be looking more up though. Head, eye, and mandible should be a little bit lower. Does that make sense? What am I drawing here? It doesn't really look like much, does it? Maybe just a little bit more careful here. supposed to be ahead. And then two claws coming around the tree. Shoulder. And then I think that'll do. And then the other tree comes down. Like this. He's practically standing on the roots. And then let's get some shrubbery. And then, yeah. This is basically our scene. We are over time already. But let's just put some suggestions of... Should finish this log here. Some shrubbery behind. And then we can do, let's go straight to our shadow layer. The shadow layer. Right? All this is shadow. There's so much shadow. Leaves. These are all leaves. Leaves. Should this all be? I still want to see the Meenlocks, though. Like, you know what I'm saying? Have I messed up the Meenlocks? Made them too? Made them too much shadow? Maybe a pair of glowing eyes behind him. Yeah, that's a good idea, actually. Let's put some shade behind him. Is that gonna work? I feel like I'm really overdoing it with this one. But let's see. I should do is I have a very specific brush for leaves. Should I do it while we're here? No, I'll come back to it. I'll come back to it. I'll come back to it. Here's the tree. Meenlocks. Let's just get some. Meenlocks have shadow on them as well, or are they just gonna... I mean, they're supposed to blend a little bit, but I don't want them to disappear for the viewer. This one's gonna be way over. This is gonna be a 30-minute monster. Let me just get the eyes. I feel like that'll help. And then... just the outline... the other guys? I don't know. What do you guys think? The claws can be... and the mandibles, obviously. Alright, and then we'll put some... eyes. Although those seem too high up. Let me draw that again. I want to make them less round and more evil. Now there's many menacing Meenlocks. And the mad mage, or the manly mage. All right, this is our manly mage. He's all right. He's a little scared. And anything else we need to do? Should I go ahead and do some white? Just for... Oh, that's it. That's kind of effective, isn't it? And then... seem a little more hairy. I think that's pretty good. Some toenails. And his beard. And then get his eyes going. And I think that's going to be it. I think we're going to call it done. Just get this guy going. His claw. Clause. And, yeah. Meenlocks. They're mean. They're locky. Get some hair on this guy, too. And, yeah. Let's not overdo it. Okay. We're done. It's 10:35. We are 7 minutes over. Is that right? Yeah. And let's sign this guy. This is, twitch.tv/ToranAtkinson. That's where you can find me. And this is... I should do a different brush. Should I do a different color? Meenlocks. That's... Oh no, what have I done? Let's do it bigger. Mean. Thanks for joining me, Meenlocks. 20-minute monster. Next week, I like that they are hidden. The wizard's expression makes you look more closely to see what's going on. Wonderful. Thank you. Next week, this 20-minute monster, what are our choices? Take a look. We did Meenlock today. Next week is Necrophidius, Needleman, Nilbog, Nonafel, the Norker, and Nikodemon. That's exciting. I don't know what most of those are, so I'm going to have to look them up. Thanks for stopping by. Tune in again next week. Same bat time, same bat channel. I'm just going to add, what should we do? Should we do, red? Let's do a nice dark red. Make it just a little bit thicker. Because it's hard to read. Okay. Yeah. I guess we're done. Thanks so much, and I will see you next time on the internet.